Count three. One, two.
Let go!
That's it. I'm done.
Hello there. It's been a while. What's up, guys? It's your host, Josh, back again with another episode of the Spartan Times. It's been a minute since I hosted, man. It's been a while, but I'm back in the flesh. Yes, I am. Anyway, let's get on with the first segment. We have a couple segments today for you guys. It's five in total. So get comfortable, get some popcorn. This will be a long one. First segment, Amari. She got a good video for us going. She went around El Paso searching for the best Mexican food in town. Now, Mexican food, it's great. We all love it. So let's see what she has for us.
Hey Spartans, nice seeing you tuning in. Hope you're enjoying this fall season. Interestingly, El Paso has been ranked number one with Mexican food around the US. With that being said, we would like to know what your favorite Mexican restaurant is here in El Paso. Keep watching to see us interview some of our fellow Spartans for some of their opinions.
My favorite Mexican restaurant is probably Las Palmas, and what I get from there is the green chicken enchiladas. Probably 9 out of 10.
My favorite Mexican restaurant is Carlos and Mickey's. Rosa's Flautas. It's a 10 out of 10.
I don't think it's classified as a restaurant, but more like a food truck restaurant. It's Champion's Dog. They have really good food. I think the flautas from there are really good. Like a 10. It's really good.
My favorite Mexican restaurant in El Paso is Taco Bell. Just kidding, no. My favorite restaurant here in El Paso, Mexican food, is Don Carbone. They sell a bunch of delicious chicken, but my favorite thing off of their menu is their beef fajitas. They're super good, and they have like a baked potato and some like beans, or you could also get this macaroni salad. It's really good. That's like my go-to comfort food, and yeah, my favorite Mexican restaurant, definitely Don Carbone. Y'all should go eat there. It's really good.
My favorite Mexican restaurant in El Paso is, it would be Tacos Un Cuco. I would say the Tacos de Buche. I would recommend, it's a 10 out of 10. Yes, ma'am.
All this talk about food is making me hungry. I might try some of these places myself, and maybe you should too. After all, we are ranked number one. Well, that's it for today, Spartans. Tune in next time and hope to see you again.
That was a great video by Amari. Wonderful. Next video, next segment we have coming up is by Micah. He made a video going around school asking students why vending machines are so important to us. Why are they so al dente, you know? Like little snacks. They're great, right? So let's jump into that segment, see what he got for us.
Since the dawn of time and the discovery of fire, one thing has remained constant. One question, one universal debate. The major brands forged by the gods of earth, wind, fire, and water. Today, humanity has come together to put an end to the ancient debate.
Alright, so what is your name?
Alexis.
Amory.
Gianna Hogan.
It's Andrick.
Giselle.
Okay, Alexis, what role do vending machines play in your life?
A very important role in school. They make me happy, they give me food and nutrition, pretty, like, scrum delicious.
I would say a big role.
I think vending machines are just a good way of getting a snack in, even if you're hungry or something.
A very big part of my life.
OK,
Because when I don't want the very delicious lunch they serve here, I come here. It makes my day.
That's right. That's right. A big roll. What kind of big roll?
Because it's food.
When do you get your snacks?
Honestly, anytime I'm hungry, bro. Yeah.
How are they helpful?
Because they like feed you when you are hungry.
And what is your favorite drink from the vending machines?
Water. Because when I drink it, I'm not thirsty anymore.
Exactly. Yep. Water.
Those strawberry tarts. Doritos.
Doritos? Why Doritos?
Because they taste good.
Honestly, bro, if we could pick the ice cream, the pecan ice cream, that's just bomb.
I'm gonna have to say Dr. Pepper, the cream Dr. Pepper.
Hey, do you know you're not supposed to be here during class?
Yes.
Anyway, what role do vending machines play in your life?
They play a pretty big role, I would say.
Yeah, a pretty big role. What's your favorite drink from the vending machine?
Probably the Coke.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. He just made that look easy. He's like, you know, just super easy. After these interviews, we have come to a conclusion. Everybody has different tastes. Some people like cookies, some people like fig bars, but the one thing that unites us all is our love for snacks and drinks. Thank you for everyone for participating. I'm your host, Micah, and I'll see you soon.
Once again, another great video by my boy Micah. Coming up next for our third segment, we have Thanksgiving traditions. Now, of course, everyone's different. Everyone has their own little sauce they want to put on there, you know what I mean? But let's see what it has in store for us.
Hey everyone, today we're going to be talking about people's favorite Thanksgiving traditions. So I'm here with
Grace Marie.
And what is your Thanksgiving tradition that you really enjoy?
Well, one tradition that we do, because I'm Muslim, so in my house, we still do like our 12 prayers per day and everything. But the thing is that the man cuts the turkey. But like sometimes we break our cultural traditions and like, you know, rebel. So, yeah.
That's so cool. Okay, well, thank you for letting me know. That's actually very interesting. And I love hearing about how different cultures celebrate. So thank you for the response.
My family and I, we usually go to the Thanksgiving parade, and one of our favorite dishes to prepare for Thanksgiving is green spaghetti, which is usually cilantro with cream cheese, and not a lot of people are familiar with this, so I think it's very unique to our family.
And I'm here with
Ariana.
And what is your special Thanksgiving tradition you like to do?
So every Thanksgiving for the past 2 years and a half, we've been releasing balloons as like a memorial for like my grandfather that we lost 2 years ago on Thanksgiving. So we released balloons.
So hi, this is my niece, Nylea. Every year our families like to go out downtown and watch the Thanksgiving parade. And we're very fortunate this year that we're gonna be able to see Nylea march this year with the rest of the Pebble Hills marching band. So if you go to the parade, keep an eye out for your marching band and Nylea marching sousaphone.
I'm here with
Mrs. Hunt.
And what is your Thanksgiving tradition?
For Thanksgiving, usually I make a lot of cranberry sauce for everyone in the family. And there's like 50 people. So I make like 2 gallons of chipotle cranberry sauce and jalapeno cranberry sauce. That's my specialty. But this year, I didn't have time to make it. But Mr. Hunt, my husband, he went out last weekend to go turkey hunting. And it's really, really hard. That's one of the hardest animals to hunt, but he finally got one this year, so he brought it home at like 2 a.m. and we're there like plucking feathers and like trying to preserve the feathers so he could display them. But it was really cool that, you know, his efforts paid off and we have our own Thanksgiving turkey that he went out and got himself.
Once again, another great video for our third segment. Personally, Thanksgiving is my favorite holiday of the year because I can just stuff my face like a chipmunk, you know what I mean? You know what I mean, okay? Moving on to the fourth segment, we have Eddie and Ethan, who made a video on what are Spartans thankful for. Personally, a lot of things I'm thankful for. Let's see what students think about that.
Hey guys, my name's Eddie, and today I'll be asking Spartans what they're thankful for.
I'm here with
Devin Haslett.
And what are you thankful for?
I'm thankful for my family members, for being there for me when everybody else wasn't. Constantly getting at me about things, and I'm finally doing good, so.
That's great to hear. Alright, I'm here with
Adrian Sanchez.
And what are you thankful for?
I'm thankful for sports, man. They helped me through a lot recently, and it's just what I've been focusing on recently. It helps me motivated.
There you go. Here with
Mr. Munnen.
Mr. Williams.
And what are you guys thankful for?
Thanksgiving break.
Definitely the break. Family, friends, and my students. My colleagues, for sure.
All right. All right, I'm here with I'm here with
Analia.
And what are you thankful for?
I'm thankful for my friends.
All right, I'm here with
Marcel.
Marcel, what are you thankful for?
I'm thankful for my mom, my dad, my family, and my friends.
All right, I'm here with Nicholas. This is Nicholas DeGraw. What are you thankful for?
Not food, not family, or whatever else everybody else has been saying. I'm grateful for that money, for that moolah. I'm grateful for the green. I'm grateful for that dough. I'm grateful for my.
That was a long day of asking people what they're thankful for. Anyway, Spartans, I hope you have a great Thanksgiving, and I'm Eddie. I'll catch you later.
Now that right there was a great video with my boy Ethan and Eddie. Moving on to our last segment, football highlights. Doug, if you were not there at the game, let me paint you a picture, right? Permian's right here. You can't see the bottom, but I'm Spartans, right? Just Permian got whooped, all right? 45-28. Now, I'm just gonna let you decide who was the best MVP this game, right? Take a look. It's your boy Josh signing off. I'll see you next time, right? Peace out.